Euler's totient function is a fundamental tool in both number theory and abstract algebra. But what is it, and what are some of its values? This is an introduction to Euler's totient function, also known as the Euler phi function or Euler phi function if you prefer. The problem statement is this. Let phi be the Euler totient function. First of all, what is the definition of phi? What does it mean? Secondly, based on that definition, compute the values of phi of n for some selected values of n, 2 through 10, and also we'll jump ahead to n equals 16 and 20 because those are a little bit more interesting. All right, let's start with the definition. For n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, etc., in other words, all positive integers greater than or equal to 2, how is phi of n defined? It's a number theory definition. It's the number of positive integers, less than n that are also relatively prime to n, also called coprime. What does that mean? It means they have no prime factors in common with n. Relatively prime or coprime to n, it doesn't mean that they are prime numbers. For example, when n is 20, which has prime factors of 2 and 5, an example of a number that's relatively prime to n but not prime is 9. 9 has prime factorization 3 squared. 9 and 20 have no prime factors in common. They are relatively prime or coprime. All right, to actually do the problem, let's make a table to organize our work. So we'll make one column for a bunch of different values of n. We'll make another column where we list out the positive integers less than n that are relatively prime to n. The number of the elements in that set in each case will be the value of phi of n. I'm going to use a group theory notation for that. I'm going to call it U of n. It stands for the group of units modulo n. You don't need to worry about what that means unless you get into group theory. So that's going to be U of n, and then the final column will be the values of phi of n. So n is going to be 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then we'll jump ahead to 16 and 20 again because those are a bit more interesting. We're going to see some patterns. I would encourage you to see if you can predict the patterns based on the first few examples. All right, we start with n equal to 2. What is U of n? What are the positive integers less than 2 that are relatively prime to 2 that do not have 2 as a prime factor? Well, 1 is the only possibility. In fact, 1 will be in all of these sets, no matter what n is. Since there's only one number in this set, this means phi of 2 equals 1. Phi of this number, 2, is the number of elements in this set. There's only one element of the set, so this output is 1. It doesn't mean we are trying to match these numbers. We're counting the number of elements in the set. On to the case where n is 3. What are the positive integers less than 3 that are relatively prime to 3 that do not have 3 as a prime factor? 1 and 2. How many elements are in that set? 1, 2. Phi of 3 equals 2. It is a coincidence that the 2 here and the 2 there match. That won't always happen. In fact, it does not happen in the next case. When n is 4, what are the positive integers less than 4 that are relatively prime to 4? 1 and 3. Those are the ones that do not have 2 as a prime factor. 4 is 2 squared. How many numbers there are there? There are 2 of them. That means phi of 4 equals 2. On to n equals 5. 5 is a prime number, just like 2 and 3 are. We want positive integers less than 5 that do not have 5 as a prime factor. Well, that will be all of them. How many of those are there? 4 of them. Therefore, phi of 5 equals 4. 6 is not prime. 6 is 2 times 3. What are the positive integers less than 6 that are relatively prime to 6? There's only 2 of them. 1 and 5. 2 is not, 3 is not, 4 is not. How many numbers are there? 2 of them. Therefore, phi of 6 equals 2. The phi function here is going down in value as you jump from n equals 5 to n equals 6. But when we jump up to n equals 7, which is prime, it goes back up again in value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are the positive integers less than 7 that are relatively prime to 7. There are 6 such numbers. Maybe you see a pattern now here when n is a prime number. Go ahead and write that pattern down. We jump up to n equals 8. 8 is 2 to the third power. Therefore, the numbers we want to list out in U of 8 are the odd numbers less than 8. 1, 3, 5, and 7. The odd positive numbers less than 8. How many of them are there? There are 4 of them. Phi of 8 is 4. Perhaps you see another pattern. Phi of 2 is 1. Phi of 4 is 2. Phi of 8 is 4. You might want to guess what phi of 16 is. On to n equals 9. 9 is 3 to the second power. In U of 9, we want to avoid powers of 3, except for 1. So it's 1, 2, we skip 3, go on to 4, 5. We also want to avoid multiples of 3, so we want to avoid 6, 7, and 8. How many such numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 of them. Phi of 9 is 6. 9 is 3 squared. That's a little less clear, I think, what the pattern is here for figuring out phi of 9, but we can list these numbers out to figure out the answer. When n is 10, n is 2 times 5. U of 10, we want to avoid even numbers, and we also want to avoid 5. We have 1, 3, 7, and 9. There are 4 positive integers less than 10 that are relatively prime to 10. Phi of 10 is 4. On to 16. Did you guess the answer ahead of time? It should be 8 here, right? Based on the pattern. Avoiding multiples of 2, avoiding even numbers, we get 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, and 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 such numbers. Phi of 16 is 8. On to 20. 20 is 2 squared times 5. We want to avoid even numbers. We also want to avoid 5 and 15. 1, 3, skip 5, go to 7, 9, 11, 13, skip 15, go to 17, and 19. These are the positive integers less than 20 that are relatively prime to 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of them. It is interesting to note that 8 is 2 times 4, just like 20 is 4 times 5. Maybe that's not a coincidence. Can values of the Euler totient function be found anywhere online? Yes. One place to do it is at Wolfram Alpha. If you want to find values of Euler phi, for example, Euler phi of 20, type in Euler phi of 20. Okay, this is the Euler totient function value when n is 20. We already saw it was 8. And if you enter this, you do in fact see the result as 8. You see what the divisors are. You want to avoid multiples of these numbers when you write U of 20. Can you do anything else? Yeah, you can plot Euler of n, Euler phi of n, for example, and see a pretty interesting graph. Here are the first values when n goes from 2 to 11. It's also saying that phi of 1 is 1 and phi of 0 is 0. Don't worry about what those mean. What's more interesting is when you widen the window to let n go up to, for example, 160. These high values, if you think about it, must be when n is prime. You also have a bulk of values in the middle here. You might wonder what input n values those are. Perhaps you can predict these moderately high values correspond to values of n that are powers of primes. You can also get Wolfram Alpha to list out values of the Euler totient function in a table if you like. Essentially, what I'm doing here is I'm using Mathematica code to do so. If you want to see the first 100 values, you can enter this code like this, and the output will be a list that you can see. These are the values of phi of n when n goes from 1 to 100. Thanks for watching.